As it stands for 20th November 2018, yes, it is still profitable to mine cryptocurrencies. And most likely will be till cryptocurrencies does exist. But of course, for not for everyone. The main thing is, you know, what's your power costs, which is also the biggest mining expenses. Also, what kind of hardware you're using, what currencies you're mining. Of course, it's not as profitable as it used to be a little bit less than a year ago, December, January this year. Yes, so one of the biggest players is the your power costs, because in most of the cases your only cost is power, not counting the hardware. And what does that mean? That means that you can stay longer in this dangerous mining environment, and as longer you can survive in this, as bigger gains you can expect in the future. My power costs here in Ireland is 13 cents per kilowatt, which is quite high, probably about more than average worldwide. I would say so, yeah. GPUs currently doesn't make me any money for mining, only cost me money, because the power is so expensive, and there's the power costs can't cover the GPU mining profits. The GPU mining profits can't cover the power costs. But luckily there is a few ASICs which are still profitable. And also this new thing, FPGA mining. As you might seen in my previous video, I was testing out the FPGA BCU1525. And at that time, you know, we're still very limited software out there which can be used on these cards to mine cryptocurrencies, but it's starting to get more and more as they are quite profitable. And at that time I was mining in ExosCoin, and it was bringing about $3.50 a day, and currently probably a lot less now, maybe a dollar a day or so, as the price has dropped significantly last few days. So I'm running Whitefire's Bitstream now. It's a private Bitstream. The same guy who developed the Nexus Bitstream and the 0x token Bitstream. I'm running his Bitstream. It's still private. Probably he doesn't want to release yet to public. Probably he wants to be 100% sure before he releases to public. I'm using this Bitstream to mine some currency, and I'm making a profit, $12 in 24 hours per one card. But as you remember, the biggest issue that I had, it was the cooling. But I figured out slightly, you know, how to cool down the FPGA card with air. I have seen some guys, you know, the technicals channel, he's using the tool Waterbrock, which seems to do a very good job and cools down the FPGA card to 45 Celsius. I have done this to 67 Celsius with the air cooling. What I did, I took the Antminer S9 case and put the FPGA card in there. Let's see what I did there. So this is what I have done to cool down the BCU 1525.
I took a Unminer S9 casing and removed all the useless shit what's inside, and did put the FPGA inside of it. And this way I'm air cooled down the FPGA card. Seems like on the 90% performance, I can cool down the FPGA to 67 Celsius, which is still very high, but it's better than I had this in my previous casing. So I also removed the cover from the FPGA card, what's in the into the Unminer S9 case. This way I connected the this case to the motherboard. So this is the power cable which goes to the power supply, which feeds the FPGA with the power. And this cable goes to the riser card from the power supply, which feeds the power to the riser cable. And this is the riser cable which comes out from here and connects to the motherboard, Biostar TB250. And this is the USB cable which is connected to FPGA card, and it connects to the motherboard. So yeah, this way I'm mining, and the card is drawing 310 watts about. And yeah, it's cool down to 67 Celsius. I'm mining some private Bitstream, which currently does $10 per 24 hours, which is not bad, which is actually quite good in these kind of market crash prices when the Bitcoin is only $4,500.
So guys, to answer your question, if mining is still profitable, yes it is, but it's a dangerous game. Whoever will do most efficient, of course the return of investment is, your profitability isn't as high anymore as it used to be less than a year ago. But yeah, it's still profitable for some of them, who, depending on what hardware and what's your power costs and all the running costs. This makes your profit. And if GPU mining will ever come back, I'm not really sure. It might not, depending on the currency prices. Like if it comes back after a year, there might be a more efficient GPUs which will mine more efficiently and will have a lot more profit on them. So the old GPUs, what you can do, maybe throw in a bin or something. Yeah, but if the profit stays the same, I also did lose money on the investing in GPU mining rigs. But it's okay. It's part of the mining game. You know, it's dangerous. Everyone is signed up to it. I hope this video helped you. If it did help you, share with your friends. Subscribe the Mining Hardware YouTube channel if you like this video to not miss any more videos. And thanks for tuning in, and see you on the next video, guys. Bye bye. Take care.